Thank you, Mr. Chairman, for yielding. Professor Gerhardt said, if what we are talking about today is not impeachable, then nothing is impeachable. I'm reminded of my time on the House Judiciary Committee during the 1990s impeachment and as well a number of federal judges. I was guided then not only by the facts, but by the Constitution and the duty to serve this nation. I believe, as we greet you today, that we are charged with a sober and somber responsibility. So, Professor Karlan, I'd like you to look at the intelligence volume where hundreds of documents are behind that in the Mueller report. Professor Karlan, you studied the record. Do you think it is, quote, wafer thin? And can you remark on the strength of the record before us?
So obviously it's not wafer thin. And the strength of the record is not just in the the July 25th call. I think the way you need to ask about this is, how does it fit into the pattern of behavior by the president? Because what you're really doing is you're drawing inferences here. This is about circumstantial evidence as well as direct evidence. That is, you're trying to infer, did the president ask for a political favor? And I think this record supports the inference that he did.
What comparisons, Professor Karlan, can we make between kings that the framers were afraid of and the president's conduct today?
So kings could do no wrong because the king's word was law. And contrary to what President Trump has said, Article 2 does not give him the power to do anything he wants. And I'll just give you one example that shows you the difference between him and a king, which is the Constitution says there can be no titles of nobility. So while the president can name his son Baron, he can't make him a baron.
Thank you. The founding father, George Mason, asked, shall any man be above justice? And Alexander Hamilton wrote that high crimes and misdemeanors mean the abuse or violation of some public trust. As we move quickly, Professor Feldman, you have previously testified that the president has abused his power. Is that correct?
Yes, ma'am.
What do you think is the most compelling evidence in this impeachment inquiry that would lead you to that?
The phone call itself of July 25th is extraordinarily clear to my mind in that we hear the president asking for a favor that's clearly of personal benefit rather than acting on behalf of the interests of the nation. And then further down the road, we have more evidence, which tends to give the context and to support the explanation for what happened.
Professor Karlan, how does such abuse affect our democratic systems?
Having foreign interference in our election means that we are less free. It is less we, the people, who are determining who's the next winner than it is a foreign government.
I think it is fair to say that the president's actions are unprecedented. But what also strikes me is how many Republicans and Democrats believe that his conduct was wrong. Let's listen to...
It is improper for the president of the United States...
Listen to the colonel.
It is improper for the President of the United States to demand a foreign government investigate a U.S. citizen and a political opponent.
Professor Feldman, in light of the fact that the President asked for an investigation and then only when he was caught released the military aid, is there still a need for impeachment?
Yes, ma'am. Impeachment is complete when the President abuses his office, and he abuses his office by attempting to abuse his office. There's no distinction there between trying to do it and succeeding in doing it, and that's especially true if you only stop because you got caught.
Over 70% of the American people believe, as I said, what the president did was wrong. We have a solemn responsibility to address that, and as well, our fidelity to our oath and our duty. I'm reminded of the men and women who serve in the United States military. And I'm reminded of my three uncles who served in World War II. I can't imagine them being on the battlefield, needing arms and food. And the general says, do me a favor. We know that general would not say, do me a favor. And so in this instance, the American people deserve unfettered leadership and it is our duty to fairly assess the facts and the Constitution. I yield back my time.